So every so often I get a question from somebody who's looking to clear off space from their hard drive. And they do a search and they find this folder in their home folder under Library, Application Support, Mobile Sync. There's a backup folder and there's a bunch of these folders in here. Some of them are pretty big. If I grab this folder, you can see there's a ton of files in it. Command I to get info, I can see it's almost 27 gigs. And they figure out that these backup files here are backups of their iOS devices, iPhones, iPads, iPod Touches, and such. And when they think about it, they think, well, why do I have all of these? Sometimes there are just three here, but sometimes there are dozens of these things and they take up a ton of space. And these are indeed the backup files for your devices. When you go into iTunes and you back up your device, it creates a folder and it puts all this stuff in it, and it's a full backup of your device. But if you only have, say, one iPhone or an iPhone or an iPad, why do you have a ton of these different files, and can you get rid of them to clear off space? Well, usually you can get rid of a lot of them, but you shouldn't do it here. You should actually get out of this. This is under Library, Application Support, and you shouldn't mess with the files in here. But you can get access to them by going into iTunes. And in iTunes, you can go to iTunes Preferences and click on Devices. And iTunes, of course, is the app making these backups, so it keeps a record of them. And I can see here three different backups. Two of them really recent, and they're my current devices, so I want those. But I do have this older device that hasn't been backed up in a while. I can click it and I can select Delete Backup, and it will cleanly do the deletion of all those files for me and do it in the proper way. I can also, by the way, control click on it, not only do delete, but do Show in Finder to jump to it, or select Archive, and what it will do is it will then save this backup and not delete it and replace it with a new backup the next time I hit the backup button or sync my device. So for instance, if I was about to upgrade to a new version of iOS, I may want to do that and then just basically save the state of my current device as it is now before the backup and not have that overwritten. Of course, that will then add to the clutter, so then you do want to go back and delete that backup later on. You can see it gives you a date and time here when you do an archive backup, so you have some reference point.